Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Yaqulullahu azza wa jal fi kitabihi al-kareem. Ba'da an aqula a'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. Kalla bal la tukrimun al-yateem. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wa ahlul uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli amin ya rabbil alameen. When talking to the Quraysh, Allah azza wa jal complains about different kinds of crimes that they committed, not just against Allah but against other people also. And one of them that he listed in a very peculiar fashion is what they do towards, how they treat orphans. And he says, لا تكرمون اليتيم. You don't honor the orphan. And I was surprised when I read that the first time because I was expecting sponsoring the orphan. You don't sponsor the orphan. You don't give charity to the orphan. You don't provide shelter to the orphan. We think of taking care of orphans in terms of their physical material needs. Clothing, shelter, food, protection. These are things that, you know, any living being needs. But Allah goes above and beyond those needs that even an animal has. Even an animal can have need for shelter. Even an animal can need, you know, protection from the elements or need food for that matter. Allah goes beyond that and treats orphans in such dignified fashion and says, above and beyond all of those things, and maybe you're even giving them those things. Maybe you're even giving charity to the orphans and you're providing them shelter. But you don't treat them with respect. لا تكرمون اليتيم. A human need, like the rizq Allah gave us, the provision Allah gave us in life, it is the air we breathe, it is the food we eat, it is the clothes we wear, it's the house we live in, it's the car we drive, it's the family around us, all of those things. But one of the most priceless pieces of provision Allah has given us is our own dignity. Every human being is entitled to dignity. And Allah Azza wa Jal criticizes the Quraysh because they forget about not charity, being charitable to orphans. They don't dignify orphans. What does that teach us? It teaches us that people that are overlooked by society, their parents aren't there, they don't have family, they're completely cut off, and on top of everything else, they're not contributors because they're children. They can't make, they don't do work, and they're not people of influence. They're basically completely left out of any kind of support system. Those, even those young people deserve dignity. We're supposed to treat them with respect. And so what to speak of everybody else in humanity? Allah himself says, وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ. We honored the children of Adam. So the first lesson here that I want to remind myself of and everybody else here of is the importance of showing respect, not just to orphans, but by extension, children, just children in general. If you show them, if you treat children with dignity and with respect, and you don't insult them, humiliate them, if you don't call them names, if you don't talk down to them, if you don't hit them, if you don't do these things that basically degrade them constantly, they will grow up to respect themselves and, as by extension, respect others around them. And if you treat them like garbage, and if you treat them like they're nothing, then what do you expect from them when they grow up? So many, you know, young people, young children that have been brought up in abusive environments and tough environments grow up to be abusive and tough themselves. They are incapable of showing compassion because they weren't shown any when they were earlier in their ages. So this crime is something that creates a ripple effect in society. We have to be people that honor all human beings, starting with the point where they're children. Even children must be honored, subhanAllah. This is just a small reminder of this that I want to leave you with. In Surah An-Nisa, Allah begins, Ya ayyuhan nas, ittaqoo rabbakum. You know, humanity, be cautious of your master, the one who created you from a single person. وَخَلَقَ مِنْهَا زَوْجَهَا وَبَثَ مِنْهُمَا رِجَالًا كَثِيرًا وَنِسَاءً وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. Have taqwa of Allah in the beginning of the ayah, have taqwa of Allah towards the end of the ayah. Then he says, have taqwa of al-arham. Have, be cautious, not just of Allah, be cautious of the wombs of mothers. Right? And but when he's saying be cautious of the wombs of the womb of the mother is only important because it gives birth to a child. So honor mothers and honor children by just saying al-arham. Honor mothers and honor children. And so what do you get in the very next ayah of Surah An-Nisa, the second ayah? وَآتُوا الْيَتَامَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ. Give orphans what the monies they deserve. Why is that mentioned immediately after? Because those are people whose relation with the womb has been cut. But since you have so much honor for all relations of the womb, and you feel, you know, that these people who would have had the shelter and the loving care of their mother has been taken away from them, you're going to go out of your way to give them first. May Allah Azza wa Jal make us a society and a people that care for the orphans in our communities, extend it if your cousins are orphaned, if your, you know, your distant relatives are orphaned, going out of your way to honor them, dignify them, invite them. You know, nobody invites them to Eid gatherings anymore. Nobody calls them. Nobody thinks of remembering them. And they feel isolated because the people that used to get invited, their parents are gone now. So you go out of your way to care for them, reach out to them. honor them, and may Allah Azza wa Jalla not make us of those who he complains about when he says that you don't dignify orphans. Barakallahu li wa lakum, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.